Nikona, mi ikona.
In the early years, we certainly had our challenges musically, and we certainly had our challenges organizationally. And there were times I wondered if we would make it or not, but we did. And we had so many people right from the beginning who were really enthusiastic about the organization, and I think that really sustained the group through those challenges.
My name is Darcy, and I'm founding member of One Voice Mixed Chorus. So One Voice has been a part of my roots for 25 years. I moved to the cities in 1988. I had lived in rural Wisconsin. It was a very lonely place for someone who was self-identifying as a lesbian. And so I moved here looking for community and to expand my coming out experience. And when I got to the cities, we were reading Equal Time, which was the magazine at the time, and it advertised for a mixed chorus that a gentleman named Paul Petrella was trying to pull together both gay and lesbian voices to sing together. And that was quite exciting for me because I didn't have a lot of knowledge about the GLBT community, and even back then it wasn't a GLBT. We talked about G and L, gay and lesbian. And my head was filled with misnomers from silence from the past and even actually lack of words for identifying myself.
The very first rehearsal was amazing. It was kind of like the first time I ever went to the lesbian coffee house, except there were men there too. You know, it was just a room full of gay and lesbian people. And everybody was so just pumped, you know. It was like, okay, let's sing. And it was just unbelievable, indescribable.
It wasn't long before I felt like I had finally found my people, my community.
You know, I did want to talk about the early choreography as well, because I remember one of the first concerts, it was too darn hot, and I got to dance with Jiffy Pop and an iron. It was lovely.
Star maker, dream breaker.
Some of the original concerts, people were hesitant to sing and people were hesitant to openly be out in a public forum. I myself, being in the education field, it was very frightening for me. But I always had this anxiousness about, what if somebody sees me?
At the very first One Voice concert, there were a number of singers who were not comfortable having their name in the program to be out in the community. And one of those singers was Mary Tanucci. But one of the cool things that happened was several years later, Mary, who was working for the St. Paul school system, started the program Out for Equity, which is a way of supporting and working with GLBT students in the public schools. And now, 25 years later, One Voice has a partnership with Out for Equity, and they are a major player in our program each spring called Out in Our Schools.
Sawubona. Gay people at one time were invisible and were forced to become invisible, but now we're a part of the light. We are the light. That's where we are, and that's where we need to keep reminding people of their light and their beauty as well. I am Benjamin, and I am One Voice.
I ain't afraid.
Lizette.
I'm Char.
I'm Lucine.
I'm Robin.
I am One Voice.
In the early 90s when I was in college, I remember there was a little bit of separation, I think, between the men and the women initially, but during the 4 years that I was there, I think a lot of us came together. Yeah, I mean, I think there was a lot of support that was then lended during that process, and I think that really solidified our little OLF lesbian and gay alliance together as men and women for the first time.
Well, men and women didn't connect in the 80s. You didn't feel a need to. We knew we couldn't because they seemed to be like this different type of culture, and in some ways, you know, they very much were. And plus, lesbianism had its very connection to feminism, and I think that some men saw that as sort of, well, they are anti-man, but in a lot of ways it was just so new to think about bringing the communities together.
Yeah.
We didn't know how or, you know.
And it was an opportunity for women to really be strong in and among themselves.
Oh, yeah.
So I think a lot of us got labeled as separatists, and we weren't.
Yeah.
Which is why the mixed chorus made sense.
Right.
I am Dennis, and I am One Voice. And one thing that really struck me this month is us working on the Vote No campaign in Minnesota to not have discrimination written into our constitution in Minnesota. It really reminded me of the contrast between the support we have now and the support we had back then when the AIDS crisis was just blooming. It was in the early 80s when the AIDS crisis hit, and we had very, very little support from the outside community. In fact, we were blamed for it as gay men, for starting the epidemic and keeping it going. In the beginning, I remember feeling sort of like we were in this alone, and then slowly over time, women and lesbians in the community started to work with us in supporting us with services for people with AIDS. And I think it was a huge breakthrough in men, gay men working with women.
For those of us coming of age in the late 70s and early 80s, nothing prepared us for what was about to happen. They don't teach you in college to look at your new and beloved community of gay friends, the first people to help you lay aside your secrets and to embrace you like a second family, and pick the five young men who will be dead before your first reunion. The etiquette books are strangely silent on what to say to that guy that you had a little fling with about 6 months ago, now that you're running into him and he's lost 30 pounds and has a lesion below his ear. What could you say? It was a time of shock, devastating losses, and a numbing fear that all of the fun people, all of the people who bring you joy, are leaving the party when you just got there, with nobody left to dance with but yourself.
You.
chorus as the mother of a gay son who realized that I really had no idea what life was like for LGBT people. I live in the northern suburbs, and there was nobody else I knew that had a gay child. My son thought that he was the only one for the longest time. And what One Voice has given me individually is strength and power in my choice to be an ally, not only for my son and his partner, but for youth in my school and my community.
I'm Isabel Miller. I'm 11 years old, and my mom sings in One Voice.
I have been always in love of music, and I think it's a way that people can just communicate and just forget about the language and the culture. And when I get here and I listen to all the groups singing, I just fall in love how it gets to my heart. And when I saw this bunch of people with different lives and different stories and just united, just singing out loud and so beautiful, I just wanted to be part of it.
Michael Kiso Moore, and he was in chorus and had been in chorus for quite a while, and we were friends. We had, but he asked Barb that night if he could come to the birth of our child. So right after Anthony was born, Michael came in and we sang happy birthday to our little itsy bitsy baby. Yep. And Michael has been part of Anthony's life. I mean, we've seen him at least once a week for the last 12 and a half years.
Hi, I'm Britt, and I've been singing with One Voice for 16 years. So I've said that I really think that One Voice is like a family to me. And what I didn't know was when we started our own family that One Voice would really be my parenting community as well. Joan Wing and I were pregnant at the same time. Will and Anthony are about 3 weeks apart. They've pretty much grown up like cousins.
So we actually met in choir. We're singing a song this season called Singing in the Choir. One of the lines is, we met at the potluck supper, which is how we met. I had noticed him and was really interested, but being that this is a GLBTQ choir, didn't know if he would actually be interested in me. And so at the end of our lunch together, I said, we are going to have coffee sometime. And it wasn't until we got to the coffee shop that, lo and behold, he doesn't actually drink coffee.
Nope. Several people today have mentioned the Reclaiming Faith concert, and that was also transformative for me because that's when I discovered that all of the things that I was looking for in a faith community, I found at One Voice. I found social change and outreach. I found people acting on their highest values and beliefs.
The most fortunate pieces for me is having met my partner, Shark. We met early on in choir and started dating in the second season, and we've been together ever since. So One Voice for us is part of the family.
Yep. My name is Jorge.
I'm JD.
I'm John Whalen.
Yeah. I'm One Voice.
Darkness deepens, Lord, with me.
tour begun, and I lost my music, and I didn't know where I was, and I didn't see you again for 2 weeks.
You'll come away with
see the world live a day. Walk a mile in your neighbor's shoes, their shoes. Walk a mile.
I remember the second season that One Voice was starting, and we were at our first rehearsal, and a woman I hadn't seen before sat next to me. And I looked at her and I said, "Hi, I'm Marnie," and she said, "I'm Barbara." And I said, "Are you partnered?" And she said, "Yes, I have a husband." And I said, "Oh." And at that moment, I thought we should probably call it One Voice, Mixed Chorus, and Barbara. But, you know, I had no idea there were going to be more straight people coming. But, that, you know, that's another story.
So in 1996, Scott and I were at Pride. And as we were walking around, we came to the One Voice booth. And then these just seemed like such friendly people. And we said, "Hey, do you take straight people?" And Lizette said, "Well, I think we've had a few openly straight people before." So we signed up to audition, and when we got the call, we said, "Well, you know we're straight, right?" We came and auditioned and said to Jane, "Well, you know we're straight, right?" And I think one of our concerns is that we didn't want to come into a space that people felt as their space, as a safe space for them. But I really felt right from the start that we were just so welcomed, so warmly welcomed into this group.
Hi, my name is Katrina, and I've been singing with the chorus for 12 years now. I should point out that when I started singing with the chorus, my name was Keith. Everything is flexible. The chorus was wonderfully accepting of me as being trans, and always has been. But I sing tenor, and at first it was kind of hard for me to get to know some of the other women in chorus, but it was on a tour when one of the altos made sure that I was invited to go to her room with the other women and just enjoy their company and to get to know all the other women in the chorus. And that was really the first time that I really felt like one of the women in the chorus.
I am Marisa, and I am One Voice. One of the things that I really love about One Voice is that we are such a mix of people. Gay people, straight people, transgender people, spouses of transgender people, kids whose parents are straight, kids whose parents are gay. One Voice is really a family in the very best sense of the word.
I am Liz. And I am One Voice. But I was with the chorus for about 3 years, and this gentleman that had been a wonderful friend of mine for, you know, 6 or 7 years, and I started sort of getting romantic again, and I got really confused by that. And in the privacy of my heart, I decided, you know what, if I've found my partner, that needs to be okay, whoever he turns out to be. So I went to rehearsal, and I said, "You guys, I'm engaged." And they said, "Yay!" And I said, "To a man." And there was silence for a beat, a short beat. And then the cheering resumed with the same amount of enthusiasm and the same amount of joy.
When I joined the chorus in the fall of 2006, I had only just come out as a lesbian 2 years prior to that. I spent 52 years denying who I was. And much of my journey in the years since then has been coming to terms with considering myself two-spirit, co-gendered, use whatever term. And to do that so authentically and personally and have this community embrace that has been life-changing for me. I'm Jen. I am One Voice.
She makes me lie down in grief.
was why, never smile, never smile, that is so not yet.
Things that's really surprised me about this chorus is that they're so much more than singers. Every member of this chorus is absolutely committed to the mission.
But when we've gone out into rural Minnesota and we find people who come to our concerts there who have driven for 3 or 4 hours to get to the venue so that they can hear us and experience that time of togetherness.
Oh gosh, the tour buses are packed with fun. Normally there's at least like 2 or 3 other kids.
One Voice tour. So we, in my first season, we did a huge tour to Canada. A couple buses and we drove all the way up to Winnipeg. blew my mind. I believe we did 5 concerts that weekend. It was amazing.
We stopped at the border, and I said, okay, everybody, no jokes, have your paperwork ready, this is serious stuff. And the customs person gets on, and she said, are you guys really a choir? We said, yeah, and she said, okay, sing something for me. So we sang something for her, and she said, okay, pass. So she let us pass, and we got to Winnipeg, we had the concert, and lo and behold, she had shown up 100 miles from the border.
One of the things that I think is awesome about One Voice is how many different experiences we get to have performing with other organizations, whether it's dance troupes or musical ensembles.
Now, while I've had many favorite One Voice mixed chorus concerts over the years, I would definitely have to say my favorite was in 2011, and that's the Brave Souls and Dreamers concert. And emotionally, it just took me places that music has never taken me before. So it was really, really very special for me.
I am a 4th grade teacher, and a couple of years ago, One Voice did a concert called Different is Great, which was all about bullying and gender stereotypes and how to stand up for yourself. And it couldn't have come at a better time for me and my students. I had a little boy that year who carried around a purse, and unfortunately, there was a group of boys, one in particular, who called him a faggot. So I actually brought in all of the different songs and stories that we were using in that concert. Ferdinand the Bull, Pug Dog, we learned the song I'm Different, and we used it as a platform to talk about bullying and using hateful language and what it really means when you're calling someone gay or saying, that's so gay.
Okay. The songs kind of really get stuck in your head when they sing that one. I'm different, different, different. Nobody's like me. Different, different, different. And that's okay with me.
I would have to say that my favorite One Voice concert was Reclaiming Faith in the Spirit of Justice. It integrated music from all kinds of different faith communities. This concert made it possible for me to reclaim my own spirituality, which I had kind of turned away from because of that very fact of seeing so many faith communities treating GLBT people in what I considered to be a very unchristian way.
My name is Michael Dodson. I am One Voice.
My background in choral music had been in schools and churches, but it has been so fulfilling to me to sing with an organization that has a mission. As Holly Near says, we're singing for our lives. And so I thank One Voice for that.
And we are singing, singing for our lives. We are a peaceful, loving
all its fields in bloom, its woods.
fields and mountains green, and the wide ocean reflecting irradiance. Oh, the world is young once again. In the mist of the more iridescent and
Amen.
never give up. Never, 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 never. Oh, never, never give up. Oh, Bambalela.
Is building community and creating social change by raising our voices in song. And one of the ways that works in schools is by simply being a positive role model for kids.
But that's what our school is about, including everybody, building peace. And so I think One Voice really helps that too.
For a while, it was hard for me to be out because in school, I was always harassed about saying, people were telling me, oh, you're gay, you're such a, I'm not gonna say the word, but people would even beat me up for it. And so being open and being out with everybody in One Voice, it's just a wonderful experience.
It's so important for our children to experience One Voice and to know from an early age that, as the song says, you can be anybody you want to be. You can love whomever you will. Our Out in the Schools program does just that, teaching kids to sing and dialogue with each other about each other. This wonderful program has impacted over 30 schools and countless children statewide.
25 years ago, I wasn't even alive. 1 year ago, One Voice came to my school. I wasn't sure what to think at first, and then I found them really quite good. I wanted to be part of it. I am Autumn Rose, and I am One Voice. Jazz hands!
And my dream came true when we came to St. Francis as part of our outreach tour. I received notes from kids saying that we saved their life and that being with One Voice, surrounded by people who accept and love each other for who they are, made them feel safe and gave them hope. And for that, I will always be grateful to One Voice.
One Voice did a concert of Brahms with the concert choir at Central High School. This young woman came up to me and she said, I haven't told you this, but while we were rehearsing with One Voice over the past 3 months, my father came out as transgender and my whole family came to the concert. And it was the first time that we as a family got to experience my father and our family in a place where we could be welcomed and connected and accepted for who we are.
I'm Kathy and I am One Voice. It's been a journey for me being a teacher all these years, and it was always difficult coming out. And what's amazing about One Voice is that we come into the schools and we sing. I wish I'd seen that when I was a child.
It's an incredible experience to show up and sing in a school, because most of us can't even fathom what it would have been like to have a GLBT chorus come and just sing, just be out in our school when we were young. And for singers who are doing this for the first time, they often get on the bus at the end of the day just crying because it's such a moving experience for them.
Last year, One Voice came to sing at my school and I instantly fell in love, so I decided to audition. And now, I am Tasha and I am One Voice.
The sound of voices too.
the sound of voices three. Singing together in harmony. Surrendering to the mystery. This is the sound of voices three. This is the sound of voices three.
This is the sound of all of us. Singing with love and the will to trust. Leave the rest behind and we'll turn to
Building community.
Building community.
And creating social change.
And creating social change.
By raising our voices in song.
By raising our voices in song.
By raising our voices in song.
Years ago, I couldn't be who I was. Today, I'm me.
25 years ago, my dad was in the closet, and to this day, he's out, and I'm very happy that I can have a positive role model in my life to kind of model myself after.
That one voice works. Our mission works. People hear us. My son, who is almost 20 now, or is 20 now, came out while we were in the chorus, and I don't think he could have done that if the chorus had not been our family. Did not create a warm, comfortable environment for him to be himself in.
And so I think the mission for social change and empowering people lives out in all those stories that we have. And so for myself, it went from a place of fear and anxiousness to a place of pride and feeling very wonderful about being part of the community.
I remember this time seeing vote no signs all over the neighborhoods. Straight couples, single people, just a lot of support more than just the gay community. So I've really seen how much things have changed in the last 20 years from when we had very little support to this time sort of being supported and wrapped by a lot of different people in Minneapolis.
This mug is from the Festival 5 in Tampa, Florida. And it says, "Our voices win freedom." And our voices really won freedom.
I'm Scott Likens, and I'm One Voice. 25 years ago, I was 1 year old, and since then, it's taken a long time to discover who I am and become comfortable with that, and communities like One Voice have been a big part in helping me do that.
25 years ago, my life was full of shame, so much shame that I didn't even know it. Now I know what shame is. I'm a warrior against shame in my life and in everybody else's life, and I'm strong and I'm proud. Yihyeh beseder, it gets better.
When I joined One Voice Mixed Chorus, I was so excited to become part of the chorus, and I invited my parents to come to the first concert. But they were really uncomfortable and said, my dad said, "I'm so sorry, but I just can't come." But it worked on them a little bit, and he reconsidered. So they came to that first concert that I was in, and they haven't missed a concert since then.
It's better now because lots of schools have gay straight alliances and LGBT kids have support.
And as a parent, it's wonderful to come to this community and really feel the warmth, the love, the care, and to show our son that this is a wonderful, you're a wonderful person, this is a wonderful life, we love you. You can sing, you can celebrate with your community forever. It makes me as a parent feel very, very good. So thank you, One Voice.
We are One Voice.
You're alone, and the world throws out a lot of hate.
It's not the end. You're not out there on your own.
There's still so much in life to celebrate.
Joshua.
Cause the skies are gonna clear. There's so much more than just a here and
shining down.
It gets better, better, better. The pain will let up, let up, let up. If you fall, just get up, get up, get up. Oh, cause there's another way. It gets better, better, better. The world gets lighter, lighter, lighter. So be a fighter, fighter, fighter. Oh, just live to see that day. Yeah. Live to see that day.
To feel like you, no end in sight, fearing every day.
Just defend the part of you that's true. Find yourself,
and you will find a way. Yet to meet.
There are songs to be sung.
There are beautiful sunsets
and battles unwon.
There is love to be found
if you just look around.